I would proudly welcome Mr. Vikram Chopra, who's the co-founder and CEO of Cars 24, on stage for a session on how is Cars 24 disrupting India's used car sector. And this session is going to be followed by a fireside chat with Mr. Partha Sinha. He's the Vice Chairman and Managing Director, McCann Worldgroup. Good morning and a very warm welcome to you, and over to you, sir.
Am I audible?
It's working.
Hello. Hi, everyone. Good morning. Thanks for having me here. It's an honor to be here and present our story. So before I start, let me introduce myself. My name is Vikram Chopra. I am the co-founder and CEO of Cars 24. Cars 24 is a used car transaction business. But what we are really trying to do is an ambition of different kind. We are trying to build India's largest auto company. And when I say India's largest auto company, I exactly mean that. Not just largest used car company, but India's largest auto company. So how do we do that? Before I get into the details of how are we trying to fulfill our ambitions, let me take a step back and take you through the size of the opportunity. So India is all set to become world's third largest auto market, behind US and China. Specifically, used cars is a 4 million market today. 4 million used cars get sold every year. And that market is expected to double in the next 4 or 5 years. So used cars is the big mainstay in the entire auto segment. And specifically, it has a big headway to grow. The per capita consumption of used cars, the ownership of used cars, is still very tiny if you take benchmarks for any other geography. And the used car to new car ratio typically is 3:1 in developed markets. So India has still a long way to go. In 10 years from now, the used car market will be 3 times larger than new car market. So overall, what we are looking at is a $100 billion market today across the entire used car value chain. It's in the transaction, it's in the financing, it's in the insurance, it's in the servicing, but altogether, it's over a $100 billion market opportunity today. And in 5 years and in 10 years, we are looking at this market becoming a $200 billion or a $300 billion market opportunity. So that is the power of used cars. Used car market, as I said, will be 3 times larger than new car market. And if somebody could win the used car market opportunity, that's how you create a new player who becomes the biggest car player in India, who becomes the largest auto player in India. So how do you do that? How do you build a large used car company that in turn can become a largest auto company? You know, it turns out it's fairly simple. The problem is very elementary. Think of how any one of you have sold your car, or your friends or your family or anyone who has sold their car. It's all very archaic. All of us, when we have to sell the car, essentially start by asking a lot of people for their opinion. Then we try and meet as many people as we can. It could be used car dealers, it could be friends, it could be strangers. And then try and show them our car. A lot of test driving and inspection follows, a lot of haggle, a lot of hassle, and then you are following up for your payments and title transfer. All of it is a big mess. I haven't heard anyone telling me that they had a pleasurable used car selling experience. And this is really strange. For all the progress that the cars have made, for all the progress in that technology brings, you know, we are talking now about autonomous cars and flying cars, but selling a car is still how it was probably a century ago. Somebody who owned a car in 1890 sold the car in exactly same way as somebody who sells their car in 2015, 3 years ago. And we said that if we can change that, if we can change how cars are sold, if we can bring joy to this experience, if we can bring delight to this experience, if we can make it hassle-free, if we can make it trustworthy, you could really create a large opportunity here, because selling a car is a big pain. So how do we do that? So to explain what we do, let me take you through a video that exactly describes how we actually transform this market. How do we actually make selling a joy?
मैं गाड़ी बेच रहा हूँ, मच्छी नहीं।
क्या हुआ बाबूजी?
अरे प्राइस फिक्स करने के बाद भी बार्गेनिंग। बड़ी ऑनलाइन बायस।
वेट। सर, व्हाई डोंट यू ट्राई कॉस 24? इनका सिस्टम ही अलग है।
हाय सर।
देखो बॉस, मेरे को गाड़ी बेचने का है, टॉप कंडीशन में, इतना मिलेगा क्या?
सर, ये फेक प्राइस है। इंस्पेक्ट करके ही कार का बेस्ट प्राइस डिसाइड करते हैं।
अच्छा, अगर सही प्राइस मिला ना तो मैं मुंह छू जाता। फैंसी ओन कार है, ये क्या कर रहे हो?
सर, आपने कभी गाड़ी रीपेंट किया है या नहीं?
इससे पता चलेगा।
ये है कार की इंस्पेक्शन रिपोर्ट। अब ऑथराइज्ड बायर्स इस पर बिड करेंगे। सर, बेस्ट प्राइस इधर आपके बैंक अकाउंट में। सर, अब तो आप खुश हैं ना?
बहुत खुश।
कार्स 24, कार बेचो बेस्ट प्राइस में।
तो चलिए शूट करें।
लेट्स शूट।
सर, आपकी मुझ का उनका सिस्टम बहुत अच्छा।
सो दैट रियली एक्सप्लेन्स हाउ वी हैव टेकन an old daunting process and converted into sheer delight. Anyone of you who is looking to sell their car, try Cars 24, you wouldn't have tried something like this ever before. And what you saw in the ad is exactly how it happens. And that's the process in summary. You walk to a Cars 24 branch, we inspect your car, and when we inspect your car, we not just tell you about what's not so good about your car, but you also share what's actually nice about your car. For example, you got new tires 3 months ago, that your engine is still in a great shape, right? So we are very objective with the assessment of the car. We use gadgets that allow us to check a car in a very scientific manner. You know, something that we also show in that video. Thereafter, we run an auction for that car, which we use to discover the price, and in next 30 minutes, you have the price for your car. And if you accept, the transaction is then done right then and there. So in an hour, you walk out with the money in your bank account, with all the paperwork being the responsibility of Cars 24, and you are done. A process that could typically take people 4 to 6 weeks, and even after that, a lot of people end up not selling their car. With Cars 24, you walk into the branch, and within an hour, you have the money in your account, you don't have to worry about any documentation, and most importantly, your car is sold without any headache, without any inconvenience, without any hassle. So that's the power of what we are doing. And this is an example of our branches, a very professional experience, something that you would have never experienced before while trying to sell your car. It's an environment which allows you to feel secure. It's an environment that allows you to feel that someone is not trying to take you for a ride, but actually help you in the process of selling your car in the most convenient fashion. And we have had great testimonials. We have had a lot of people from all kinds of backgrounds coming and selling the car to us. And we have been privileged to have received such fantastic feedback for us again and again and again. So what is happening on the back end? We are buying these cars, we are buying them in an hour. What do we do with those cars? How do we make this business work? And that's where the technology comes in. That is where we are leveraging the latest technology to create a fascinating experience for the customer. As a car owner, you come to a branch and sell your car and you walk out. It's a seamless experience. But in the back end, there is a lot of complex process taking place, but it's all happening leveraging technology. We sell these cars online. We don't have any physical infrastructure at all, except the branches where we buy the car. On the back end, it's all online. It's all virtual, and it's all on a mobile app. That's it, nothing else. It's a mobile app where all these cars are uploaded and auctioned to thousands of partners, used car partners that we have across India. These partners are essentially small used car dealers that are all over the India. So that's how we, once we have bought the car from a customer, that's how we sell the car ahead. Using technology, using mobile, all online, no physical infrastructure. And this is why we have been able to build a very vast network. You just cannot buy thousands of cars every month and sell them if you had to indulge in a lot of physical yards to store the car and have physical visits of dealers or anybody else to come and see those cars. And our partners are all over India. They are small entrepreneurs, small businesses who have been into used cars for a long time. A lot of our partners, of course, want to grow their business, but their biggest problem is the supply of cars. But guess what we did? By solving for a car owner's pain, we are actually solving for the supply of used cars. And our partners, our used car dealers, just absolutely love this. Because for the entire industry of used cars, the biggest problem is supply. And why is this biggest problem? Because the car ownership is with every individual, you and me. We have our own cars, and we take a hell lot of time to sell our cars. So for anyone trying to buy those cars, it's again a very long process. It's a painful process. So supply is the problem in the market. By creating a wonderful customer experience, we solve for that problem, and that's why our dealers love us. And these dealers are spending amazing amount of time on our mobile app. On an average, they spend 2 hours every day. In a month, collectively, they are clocking over 150,000 hours. And these dealers are not just in Delhi or Mumbai. They are all over India. Today, we have over 2,000 partners who are buying the cars from us, and they could be anywhere in the country. We buy cars from the top 15 cities in India today, but we sell them to over 100 cities in India. So there's a lot of intercity and interstate movement of cars that's happening, and it's possible because on the back end, what we have built is a pure technology platform. And of course, these dealers are small micro entrepreneurs, and we also help them in several other ways. For example, we also provide them working capital financing so that they can buy more cars from us and grow their business. And when these dealers are buying more cars from us, we are able to procure more cars. And what this results in is a classical network loop. Because we do a lot of advertising on television, so we have a lot of customers who come to sell their car to us. Because a lot of customers come to sell their car, a lot many more dealers are joining our mobile app, they are joining our platform, because it's a great way for them to source the cars. And because a lot of these dealers are joining our platform, we are able to discover better and better prices for these cars, and that results in word of mouth, and more customers start coming to our branch to sell their cars. So it's a loop, it's a flywheel that has started spinning in a very strong fashion. And as a result, we are seeing our transactions growing very rapidly. We are a three-year-old company, and in 3 years, we have reached a transaction volume of 10,000 cars a month, or over 120,000 cars a year. That's the transaction volume we are talking about. In terms of value, we are talking about doing almost $300 million worth of cars a year. In rupee terms, over 2,000 crores of transactions are being facilitated in used cars through a platform in just 3 years of the business. And as I said, if you have to build a used car business, it all starts from the source. That source is the used car itself that you and I own. And by able to crack the model on how you can help customers sell their car easily, we are able to build large volumes of used car that are owned by Cars24. And because we own these volumes, we are the supply champion. We are the category supply leader. Nobody has the kind of volumes that we have at one place, aggregated of used cars, that nobody has these kind of volumes. And when you have those kind of volumes, you could actually play across the value chain. Today, what we do primarily is the transaction. We buy the car from the customer and we sell them to a dealer. But because we have this supply power, because we have this supply leadership, we can actually play across the value chain. We could be in financing, we could sell these cars directly to the customer, we could be involved in the car servicing business, and so on and so forth. A car business is not just the transaction, it's actually many more businesses put together, each opportunity being as big as the core C2B opportunity that we do today. And that's the power of what we are building. Now, taking it back, connecting it back to what I said before, today it's a $100 billion market already, probably a $500 billion market in the next decade. And hence, if you have the supply leadership, you could actually build a business that could be worth hundreds of billions of dollars. And if you do that, you will actually create not just the largest used car company, but actually the largest auto company in India. How? On the back of used cars. And on this journey, we have had some excellent partners supporting us. We are backed by Sequoia Capital, one of the leading Silicon Valley-based venture capital fund. We have XOR, which is owned by the Fiat family. So we have the legendary Fiat family also backing us in our vision to build the largest auto business in India. And then we have a bunch of other investors who are supporting us. That's all from me today, and that's all we are building India's largest auto business. Thank you.
I would now request Mr. Partha Sinha, who's the Vice Chairman and Managing Director of McCann Worldgroup, to please join us on stage. Ladies and gentlemen, this fire chat is going to be followed by question and answer. Thank you.
Yeah, that's absolutely fascinating. And so obviously the first question that comes to mind is, many of the cases we have seen that a business idea has emanated from kind of personal experience. I'm not getting to that Zuckerberg kind of personal experience. We know that was a slightly different personal experience. He tried to compare girls in like Harvard Dorm. But did your business also start from a deep personal experience somewhere?
Yes, it did. And actually, I think most of the problems that you feel strongly about make you find ways to solve them. So for me, it was a personal experience of a different kind. It was actually a business experience. So before starting Cars 24, I was doing another e-commerce business called Fab Furnish, where we were selling furniture online. And while running that business, what we realized was that the real problem was actually on the supply side, not as much on the demand side. Because what customers are really looking for in India is a bed at $150. But what you get in the market today is probably nothing less than $200 as a starting point. So if you could actually solve for the supply, you can actually create a very large business by not worrying about the customer, but actually worrying about the supply. And that was a lesson that we really took to our heart. We said to ourselves that, look, you know, everybody is trying to sell more to the consumers. Is there a problem statement where it's actually solving for the supply side? And frankly, for us, I think Cars 24 was interesting in the sense that you're solving for the supply side, but actually with the customer himself, right? So it's very interesting because all our lives we have focused on how can you help customers buy more from me. But right now, I am trying to pitch a customer, please sell your old car to me. Right? So it's just reversing the problem, whereas still sort of applying the same marketing principles to solve that problem. So that was the...
In fact, that was my next question, as it's like strange that you bring it up yourself, which is typically most businesses start on the demand side.
Yes.
And also, part B of the question is that facilitating C2C business is possibly the biggest business opportunity that there is. So whether it's an eBay or an OLX or all of them, the point is why? What prompted you to not start the entire C2C?
Yeah.
Because you are doing C2B and then B2C.
Yes.
But there is eventually a C2C possibility even with your platform.
Yes.
Right. So what kind of prompted you not to go directly to C2C and create a C2B?
Yes. That's a great question. So In my opinion, I think the classifieds kind of businesses were version 1.0 of the internet. And the reason I say so is because when you use a classified to sell a car, to sell a mobile phone, or anything for that matter, the whole process of actually selling still is with you. All you get is leads. All you get is basically contact numbers of 10 strangers that you can reach out to. But as it turns out, that has actually become more of a nuisance than of being an advantage, because you worry about meeting strangers that you don't know. You worry about your safety and security. And then the whole 9 yards you got to do yourself. You need to negotiate yourself. You need to get your car inspected like some 10 times. You need to let strangers tell you bad things about your car, and nobody likes listening bad things about their car. So the whole process is incredibly broken. Mm-hmm. And as I said in my presentation, like no one talks about selling their car in a joyful manner, right? I have never come across anybody telling, oh, I had such a great experience selling my car. So we said, like, you know, the classified model is fundamentally broken. And if you had to solve it, you have to solve for what is the real pain point, which is, I don't want to get into this mess at all. Somebody just do it for me. I still want a good price for my car. I'm not going to compromise that. Definitely, we are all value conscious, but I also want to get done with it like as fast as possible. I don't want to deal with hundreds of people. So that's why we thought that you need to take that transaction onto yourself. You need to take all that pain onto yourself and let customers just walk out with sheer delight. So that's why we thought, you know, we need to move away from trying to be a classified, but actually build a totally disruptive way of doing this business, which is the transaction model.
Okay, I mean, so far we spoke a little like as if you're sitting in an investor conference. I think I'll like shift gear a little bit, because it is a marketing and branding conference.
Yeah.
So one of the key thing we have always noticed that you always have to address a cultural issue for you to build a brand successfully. Now, one of the key cultural issue in India is our bad experience with middlemen, because you are asking the customer to walk into the den of a middleman.
Yeah.
And traditionally in our history, middlemen have always cheated us.
Yeah.
That's the feeling that every Indian has grown up with.
Yeah.
What have you done to take care of that? How do you make people believe that this is not that blood-sucking middleman? You know, that he will keep 50% of your money, and so that's the feeling people are usually left with. How did you address that?
Absolutely, and I think it's not just it's not a problem of perception of a middleman, but it's also a broader problem of a used car salesman all over the world, right?
Yes,
you typically
yes.
do not trust a used car salesman.
Absolutely.
Right? So for us, I think solving that problem has two or three different parts. I think the part number one is essentially giving customer an experience that he wasn't getting before. Right? So typically today, when you're trying to sell your car, you actually are literally on the road, literally by the roadside, trying to negotiate to sell your car. Whereas with Cars 24, you come to a branch, and that's where you sell your car, right? So as you saw some of those images, that's right.
There's some high volume discussion going on. I think they're planning to sell their cars. I don't know what, but
So first of all, the experience is very different, right? That itself brings a lot of trust. When you walk to a Cars 24 branch, it's a nice looking branch. You are welcomed properly. You are offered tea and coffee. So some doing like real basics, which seems so obvious, but unfortunately don't exist in the used car transaction at all. Somebody told me that when you're trying to sell your car, everybody makes you feel that it's your problem that you're trying to sell your car, right? Whereas with us, we are actually welcoming you and saying that you are still my customer. While the transaction is the other way around, where I am buying from you, but you're still my customer and I treat you like a customer. So I think that fundamentally builds a lot of trust with the customer. Another example I actually talked about was how we talk them through the inspection report. We don't just highlight what's not good about your car, but we also tell you what actually is really nice about your car. And you know, nobody likes to hear bad things about their car, period, right? People want to keep hearing good things about their car. They are emotionally attached to it. So that's another thing we ensure we do all the time. And lastly, you know, while it appears we are a middleman, but actually we are not. Because a transaction in a used car actually happens across three or four different chains of middlemen today, traditionally. Whereas now with us, you have an end dealer that could be anywhere in the country buying the car. So when you walk into a branch in Gurgaon, you could actually have a dealer sitting in Ludhiana buying that car from you, right? Directly. Today, when you try and sell that car otherwise, the car will be first sold in Gurgaon, then somebody will buy it in Chandigarh, and then somebody from there will buy it in Ludhiana. So you actually reduce the number of transaction middlemen by being tech enabled.
Are we out of time?
Yes.
Okay, so I suppose I will ask you one last question, and which is again about branding. I was in a Google BCG conference about 4 or 5 days ago, and they said that the biggest change that has taken place in the internet is it used to be about 3 M's, which was about metro, millennial, and male, and it's actually moving to 3 V's, which are vernacular, video, and voice. So which means the basic temperature of the internet is changing. Now, I have noticed one thing, that most of the internet brands which are primarily built on the digital space, use humor, at times a little smart-alecky thing to develop their brand. And like one place I remember we had a lot of resistance because that brand used to be like that and we changed it was Paytm. Oh. And like Paytm does advertising which looks like it could have been of a bank, or it could have been, it's like very, very heartwarming stuff. So why did you decide to move to humor and not, because the point that you are making is that it's an emotionally highly rewarding space and it's going to only grow, right? It will go to small towns and smaller towns, and because of the mobile penetration and because of Jio, which is, as they say, that India is pre-Jio and post-Jio. So, you know, like because of Jio, I think it will become far more basic and fundamental. So why do you think that, the world of internet brand creation, which was based on a little bit of lightheartedness, is important? Or do you think that, you know, it's a thing that you will evolve over time and you will look at the market and decide?
Yeah, no, I think that's a great question, something we keep thinking about all the time. So I think in my mind, a lot of this will also evolve for a brand like us. But today, the kind of customers that we today get are early adopters. You know, in the bigger scheme of things, India consumers are selling some 4 million cars every year, or 40 lakh cars every year. Out of that, we are buying 1 lakh.
Right? So we are still getting the 3 M's.
Yes.
So metro, millennial, and male.
Exactly. So yeah. So who we are selling to, who we are buying from today are still those early adopters, millennials, younger people, the first to adopt to technology, the first who are curious about a new offering. But I think as we look into our next 3 years journey, where we look to move this 1 lakh cars that we buy a year to 5 or 6 lakh cars a year, and as we move to smaller cities. So today we still buy cars primarily in the top 15 cities. And in 2-3 years, we are looking to move to the next 50. So I think when we move in that direction, you're absolutely right. We need to revisit a lot of how we communicate, because we need to account for the new set of customers who we start acquiring at that point.
That's great. Is there time for question from audience, or so thank you very much.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, Mr. Sinha, and thank you, Mr. Chopra. I would request Mr. Mehraj Dubey, he's the Vice President Marketing of Zee Media, to please join me on stage and to please give a token of appreciation to both of them for joining us here this morning. Thank you so much, gentlemen.